Hi everyone, Darren from DrayTek Australia and New Zealand, and I'd like to introduce you to our latest series of routers, the Vigor 2866 series. Now the Vigor 2866 series is not a replacement for the 2865 series, even though the models and features are almost exactly the same. We've mostly introduced these as a substitute for the 2865 series to meet global supply chain shortages, which might mean some stock for the 2865 series models might run low from time to time in the foreseeable future. The good news is that these should be available if and when the others aren't, or vice versa, and the only real difference is that the 2866 series also support G.fast, which is a newer and faster type of DSL technology available in some countries. Other DSL technologies that most of us are familiar with here in Australia include ADSL, VDSL and VDSL2, where the final part or last mile of the internet connection changes from optic fibre to copper wires up to the premises. Now G.fast isn't really used here apart from some fibre to the curb NBN connections, and even then the modems are usually supplied by NBN Co, and they've also since announced that these connections will be upgraded to optic fibre soon anyway. What most people will be using these for is VDSL2, which is currently needed for fibre to the node and fibre to the building NBN connections. VDSL2 support in the 2866 series also includes 35B super vectoring if you have access to that, and all models will also work on ADSL if you're still waiting for your NBN connection. If you don't need VDSL2, the Vigor 2866 series also have a gigabit Ethernet WAN port, which can connect to all other types of NBN, including fibre to the premises, hybrid fibre coaxial, fixed wireless and satellite. Even fibre to the curb, whether using VDSL2 or G.fast at the moment, as well as if or when it is upgraded to optic fibre all the way to the premises, will require a router with an Ethernet WAN port if you want to add Wi-Fi or perhaps upgrade an ISP supplied router to something with better features. The Wi-Fi models can also be connected to wireless ISPs or hotspots, even a mobile phone hotspot, and all models can connect to 3G or 4G LTE connections using a USB modem. There's even two models that can connect to 3G or 4G LTE with just a SIM. Performance-wise, the 2866 series includes similar features to the 2865 series, including hardware acceleration, which includes increased hardware NAT and routing, offering up to 2.3 times faster NAT performance with both WANs enabled, compared to the standard performance with hardware acceleration disabled. Just keep in mind that the throughput figures shown here would be dependent on having a G.fast connection. Without that, expect similar throughput figures to the 2865 series. Hardware QoS providing up to 2.6 times faster performance, prioritizing critical applications like VoIP, conferencing, and video streaming. You'll find it in the web user interface under bandwidth management in the latest firmware. So up here are the hardware QoS settings, while down here are the usual software QoS settings. And hardware IPsec performance, which automatically accelerates the first 16 VPN tunnels to connect. If any disconnect, the next in line will pop in to take its place. Let's take a look at the models. First up, we have the Vigor 2866. This one has no Wi-Fi, but has all of the other features, including a DSL WAN port, which can be connected to G.fast, VDSL, VDSL 2, or even ADSL. A switchable gigabit Ethernet WAN port, which can be connected to any type of internet connection requiring one of those. If you don't need it for an internet connection, it can alternatively be configured as an extra LAN port. 5 gigabit Ethernet LAN ports to connect PCs and other devices, and 2 USB ports which can be connected to a 3G or 4G USB modem, or a USB flash drive or hard drive for sharing files on a network, or collecting syslogs. Or you can connect a USB printer to make it accessible on a network, or even a USB thermometer to monitor environmental temperature and receive email or text alerts if it gets too hot or cold. If we compare it to the Vigor 2865, we can see it looks identical. Inside we have support for up to 32 VPNs, which can be either LAN-to-LAN or dial-in VPNs, or up to 16 SSL or open VPN tunnels. Hardware acceleration, 60,000 NAT sessions, a powerful object-based firewall, up to 16 VLANs and 8 LAN subnets, app QoS so you can prioritize different apps with a single click, and a whole lot more. I'll leave a link to the product page below so you can check out the full range of features and performance advantages. The Vigor 2866 AC has all of the same features, but also includes 802.11ac Wi-Fi, which features 2x2 MIMO and offers up to 400 megabits per second on the 2.4 gigahertz band and up to 867 megabits per second on the 5 gigahertz band. It also features the latest WPA3 wireless encryption method, wireless WAN, Wi-Fi mesh capability, and a hotspot web portal if you'd like to offer Wi-Fi to guests or customers. Around the back, you'll find an on-off switch and antennas. Those antennas are removable and are an SMA type connector, which allows higher gain antennas to be fitted if you want to extend the range. DrayTek have the ANT1205 and ANT1207 available, or the directional ANT2520. The Vigor 2866 VAC is the same, but also has a built-in analog telephone adapter for VoIP. You can connect up to two analog telephones into these ports to make VoIP calls, or connect a cordless base station with multiple handsets if you like. You can also connect those ports to an analog PABX system, just like standard PSTN lines, which is great for a small office to add a couple of VoIP lines to an existing phone system. The Vigor 2866 AX model features the latest 802.11ax Wi-Fi standard, which offers distinct advantages in high density Wi-Fi deployments. That includes OFDMA, which splits a single frame into groups of subcarriers, allowing multiple users to transmit simultaneously. Another feature in 802.11ax is BSS colouring. Normally, APs have to take turns to transmit if using the same radio channel so that the data doesn't get mixed up. BSS colouring means that data from each source can be individually identified so that APs can now transmit at the same time on the same radio channel without having to wait their turn. Two other models are featured which have built-in SIM slots to connect to 3G or 4G LTE connections. That's the same wireless network that mobile phones use to surf the internet. You can actually fit two SIMs into these, with the second one coming into play if the first one isn't working. The primary one goes in the bottom slot and the top slot will be the backup connection. The first of those models is the Vigor 2866L. Now, this model doesn't have Wi-Fi to create a wireless LAN. Those antennas you see are for the 3G, 4G LTE connection. You might also notice one USB port instead of two on the front. The second USB port is sacrificed for the LTE modem inside. The second model is the Vigor 2866 LAC. This one does have Wi-Fi and it's the same 802.11ac Wi-Fi standard as the Vigor 2866 AC model. Looking at the web user interface, I won't go into too much detail here because it's identical to the Vigor 2865 series, which I went through a little while ago. For example, here are both the dashboard pages and the menus down the left-hand side, and you can see that the only difference is the model name at the top. There is one difference though. If we go into WAN internet access, for WAN 1 we see that G.fast is also mentioned, as well as ADSL and VDSL2. And we have the usual PPPoA or PPPoE connection types, as well as MPoA with a static or dynamic IP address. I'll leave a link to the Vigor 2865 series video below if you'd like to check that out. I'll also include a link to a test drive of the web user interface so you can go through it in even more detail. I will briefly point out a couple of features I mentioned. WAN 3 and WAN 4 here are how we can connect to a wireless ISP or Wi-Fi hotspot, such as a mobile phone's wireless hotspot. We first have to enable either 2.4 GHz or 5 GHz, depending on which we want, back under WAN General Setup. Then under WAN Internet Access, we can configure the details, including our mobile phone's Wi-Fi password. LAN VLAN is where we can set up our VLANs, and we can also assign the four possible SSIDs in each band for our Wi-Fi networks to these as well. That can be useful if you have a guest Wi-Fi network that you don't want to be able to access the rest of the LAN. Hotspot Web Portal is where we can set up a public Wi-Fi network, and there's options there to set up a landing page or require a social media login. And you can set up bandwidth or time restrictions for anyone connected. Hardware acceleration I covered in the 2865 series video, so check that one out if you'd like more information about that. The Vigor 2866 series does offer more throughput than the Vigor 2865 series if you're able to connect it to a G.fast internet connection. Firewall, object setting, bandwidth management, Here's our app QoS. So here you can just click on an app and set it to either high or low priority. VPN and remote access. Here you can set up to 32 dial-in VPN tunnels or 32 LAN-to-LAN VPN tunnels. VPN trunk management is where you can set up VPN load balancing. Under wireless security, we find WPA3 SAE or a mixed WPA3-WPA2 option if you don't have devices that support WPA3 yet. There's also OWE, which encrypts the data for wireless clients, making it harder for hackers to intercept and see what's going on. All the usual features we've come to expect, like AP discovery, airtime fairness, band steering, and roaming, which forces roaming wireless clients to connect to closer APs with stronger signals as they move out of range, ensuring that all wireless clients are receiving the best possible performance and no single AP is bogged down trying to service clients that would be better served by another AP. And down the bottom are the usual system maintenance and diagnostics options. And we can centrally manage VPNs on up to 8 remote DrayTek routers, up to 20 Vigor APs, and up to 10 Vigor switches. The Vigor 2866 series can also be managed using the Vigor ACS2 or Vigor ACS3 central management applications. That includes SD-WAN features in Vigor ACS3 now, as well as a drag and drop hub and spoke VPN creation wizard, and many other features. Okay, so that is DrayTek's Vigor 2866 series router range, which come with a 2-year back-to-base warranty. For more information about all DrayTek products, please check out our website at www.draytek.com.au. If you have any questions, please comment below, or you can send us an email to sales@draytek.com.au, or just give us a call on 02983888899. Please like and subscribe below before you go, and if you'd like a notification anytime we put up a new video, please give the bell a click too. Thanks and bye for now.